What's up everyone, how's it going? Welcome back to another video. In this video I'm going to be showing you the best special abilities for every position in your squad. Before moving any further, let me just show you guys. The season has just ended and I have placed first in the league. We are the champions. Today Atletico Madrid has also been named the champion of La Liga. And yeah, anyways, we placed second in the Champions League. We lost in the final to this Moshinchi FC. I cannot pronounce the name honestly. Anyways, let's just head over to the video. Let's start off with the goalkeeper. So the best training for the best special ability to train for your goalkeeper is a penalty kick stopper, because one-on-one stopper almost never comes into play while you're playing the game, whereas penalty kick stopper can be crucial in order to save penalties for a crucial match, because the only crucial matches go over to the penalty shootout. Anyways, moving on further to the defensive centers, the best special ability for defensive centers is the defensive ball, because aerial defenders aren't the best ones to be training as for the DC, whereas for DL and DRs, it's better to train aerial defender because they're more, you know, likely to interrupt corners. Okay, so moving on further to DMC, it's better to have a playmaker DMC because the playmaker special ability comes into play and is the best used when your player is either an AMC or a DMC, because both of these positions are central positions, and that's what a playmaker does. It controls the play in the central position, right? So for AMC you must also have a playmaker, as well as for DMC it's better to have a playmaker special ability. Moving on to the AMRs and AMLs, the best special ability for them is without a doubt Shadow Striker, because these are the guys that have to score most goals and these are the guys that get the most chances to strike from a long range. We can also use Shadow Striker for an attacking middle center, but there are some conditions to them. I'll explain them later in the video. Anyways, for the AMRs and AMLs, better to have Shadow Striker as their special ability. Whereas coming forward to the strikers, it's better to have either free kick specialist for them or penalty kick specialist for them, and a Shadow Striker, because this guy is an AML. That's why I have a Shadow Striker over here, whereas for ST I have this free kick specialist. And another thing that you guys need to keep in mind while giving free kick specialist ability to a player is that it must be two-footed player. A single-footed player must not be a free kick specialist, whereas you must always prefer to have a two-foot player as a free kick specialist, because it can now curl the ball both ways. As for the corner, as for moving over to, you know, the middle centers, it's better to have a corner specialist special ability for the middle centers, or either the penalty kick stopper special ability for the playmakers for the middle centers, because, you know, while once your team gets into a penalty shootout, then you have to, you know, come in and get a penalty specialist as a middle center, because your strikers and your wingers might already be occupied in order to take the first four penalties, but for the fifth penalty, and for it to be, and that is mostly the decisive penalty, for it to be going in, you need to have a penalty specialist as a middle center, an extra, you know, point. Anyways, in case you have a middle left and a middle right in your team, the best special ability you can give him is a dribbler special ability, because because most of the times the middle left and middle rights move on further and they become wide wingers, in which case it is important to have a dribbler special ability so they can move on further as far as in the field, and in order to assist your strikers and wingers. So yeah, that is it. Another thing that I want to be saying is that an attacking middle center can also be a Shadow Striker, but only in the case that you do not have strikers, you are playing striker free. If you are playing striker free, then your attacking middle centers can have a Shadow Striker special ability. Otherwise, it's better to have the playmaker special ability for your attacking middle centers. And that is it for this video, guys. I hope this one helped you. Make sure to take notes. Until then, I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.